He saw the best in me. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me.
Welcome to the Jeremiah Interdenominational Missionary Church, where Jesus is Lord. And we have our co-producer that's on here with us tonight. And we'd like to spotlight people when they give things back to the community. And he recently did a give back to the community, start the school event that he just recently did. And it turned out very, very well. And so I just wanted to give you a hats off for that, doing that, because with COVID, you know, people weren't able to see each other and do things like that because they felt like, you know, it was an endangerment. And now we're back to that point now where our children are going back to school, and they're asking people to get COVID tests again and the flu shot, and they're selling masks and stuff like that. So it tells me something that we need to be careful before it gets worse. You know, people are going all over the country, people going out the country, come into the country, and they've been doing that now for almost 3 or 4 months. So, you know, this is that time of the year where allergy season is bad. I know, because I have a seasonal body. But the event that you had, it had a very good turnout. And I really want to thank you for doing that, because I saw family members and friends and things that I hadn't seen, you know, since prior to COVID. And so it was a very nice event, and you gave away some nice things to the kids, and that was important, you know, because they need to be recognized.
Yeah, always. The youth always need to be recognized. You know, the generation, younger generation, and need a little bit of guidance, you know what I mean? It's a lot going on out here. Yeah, the event did turn out real, real nice. You wasn't the first person that said it. I got a lot of feedback from it.
Yeah, I've gotten people that email and text me and told me, oh, that was really nice. I was glad we got together.
Like, when the next one
But you know what? We did not do, I know that you're the co-producer of this show. They don't see that much. But you please introduce
myself. Well, if you didn't know, I am Mr. Liscio Sport, entrepreneur. Yeah.
And you're the co-producer for all my shows.
Co-producer of our show, Let's Talk with Paula, Lady Nighthawk, and the Jeremiah.
And so he said, well, we're doing the church show? I said, well, yeah, because the church people need to know information, too. So we found that out during COVID, right? And we didn't want to leave them out, and come to find out that a lot of senior citizens, they watch all the shows, but a lot of senior citizens watch the church show. Because we were given the same, we found out we had to give out the same information to them that we were given to Let's Talk of Paul and Lady Nighthawk. And so it became, you know, always spiritual, because we always believe in the Lord, and the Lord brings together, and look what happens. He's so awesome that a lot of us survived, but a lot of us did not. We know family members, and we know close friends. I know young people my son's age and older that have passed on. Just recently, a 22-year-old, hats off to that family, has passed on. And then from the respiratory problems, you know, COVID's been changed so many times. You know, I say all of it's COVID, because COVID is a respiratory problem. And a young girl died of pneumonia, you know, and so, you know, it's still out there attacking everybody. You don't know what it's called. I don't even know what the new name for it is at this point, but it's just that we still need to be vigilant. And when we're in large crowds and people had masks on, you know, some people didn't, but you had a lot of people that had masks on. And if you needed a mask, it was, you know, masks that were available for people if they wanted to have a mask. And I thought that was a good thing, too.
Yeah, it was outside, so it was a lot of social distance, you know.
Yeah, because you could see they were all spread out. Like family by family and friends. They were, everybody had their own little table, and they were together, you know. And it was spread. It really was. If you didn't design it that way, it just worked out that way. And I thought that was a good thing, because, you know, families were sitting with families, or friends were sitting with friends, and chairs were, you know, provided.
It was perfect.
Yeah, and the food, perfect. It was more than enough food.
What was it?
Yeah, because we wound up giving food away, which was good because you never know what people have at home.
They call it a doggy plate.
Yeah. Well, I'm not even talking about doggy plates. It was some food that we had in pans that we had.
Oh, trays.
Yeah, that we gave trays to certain people. Or they took half and somebody else took the other half, you know. Because people still having a hard time with, you know, purchasing food, you know, gas, going to work and stuff like that, because everything is going up.
Right.
I feel like some of the companies are trying to regroup some of that money that they lost. And so we're paying for it now.
Yeah.
Well, retail, cut your hours back, okay? Because it's that time of the year that they normally do. So if you work in retail, you're not making as many hours, you know what I mean? And so it makes it hard for everybody, you know? I am glad that it was a lot of other business owners that was out there, and I see that they're all young people that are out there doing the right kind of business, not out here doing drugs and, you know, those kinds of things.
Right,
they're real people out there doing real entrepreneurship. And that was a blessing all by itself. And I thought that was great to see you young guys doing something that's productive, you know, for the community, and y'all are doing it the right way. You know, y'all not doing it the way it might have been done a long time ago. People thought they had to sell drugs. There is a different way. You don't have to sell drugs to make a living. You know, you can work and do your little thing on the side, you know. But it's a whole lot of artists that are out here that, you know, creativity is something else. You can see that on television with everybody have these commercials now.
Right.
That everybody's selling something, you know, and it's a good thing. I would rather see you selling something. The Lumi commercial really gets to me because the way she started out, but look at her now. She has more than one type of commercial. She got her product inside the store now, you know. We got some young youth that are minorities that prior to COVID, I think they were making candles. And their product got put inside the store for a minute. You know what I mean? I'm not sure if it was still there. But, you know, we saw them on the news quite a bit, and they were like, I think, 8 and 10. I'm not even sure, because their mother told them that if they wanted to buy video games, that they had to create a business, you know, and that's what they did.
That's smart.
But we have a lot of gifted people out here like you and your friends, and then you work as well, you know, and they do too. So, I mean, I think that COVID, you know, it had some bad things, but it was a lot of good that came from it as well.
The COVID definitely did keep distance from a lot of people. Like I say, it was just good and bad, you know. The event, it was like a family reunion. Like you said, friends and family, you know, people that I didn't even know came and enjoyed themselves. We had Moon Bounce, the ice cream truck, you know, had games out there, DJ, and a couple vendors. It turned out real good. And like I said, a lot of people already like, oh, when the next one? We want another one, like, today. I'm like, yeah, wait till next year. You know? Just got to catch the next one.
And so that was your, not during COVID, but since COVID, that would have made your fifth event. If we had not hit COVID, you would have had more.
Yeah, COVID was 2 years. So 2 years we didn't do anything. And then a year after that.
Everybody still was trying to see.
Yeah, trying to figure out what's going on.
Right.
You know, so after it like let up a little bit, then, you know, we was like, oh, why not? Well, let's have it. Let's do it. And it happened.
And it was a good time because it's just before the kids had to go back to school on Monday. You know, so they got a chance to get out and play. And I want to shout out to the police officers that was out there, the park police, that, you know, they didn't come and sit up underneath of us, but they made sure that we were safe where we are. So they came, and then one of them came and, you know, just said they commended us about how, you know, peaceful and good, and you see the kids.
Offer them food, offer them food, drink, you know,
they said
good.
Yeah,
I mean, but,
good.
You know, it was only right, you know, you came, might as well get a plate, you know, get something to drink, but he said they already ate, so, you know.
And they were glad to see that it was an event that was like a family event, you know, and so he said, man, y'all doing the right thing. I mean, he said this to me, they are doing the right thing. You know, it's not no real loud music out here. Mm-hmm. You don't smell nobody smoking no drug. Mm-hmm. I mean, did I say that right? Mm-hmm. What did you say, smoking dope? Whatever. You don't smell no marijuana out here. Mm-hmm. You know, you don't see nobody drinking because kids are around, mm-hmm. you know. And then, and he just gave y'all a compliment all mm-hmm. by himself. So he said, if y'all got a problem, gave me his business card, gave somebody else his business card. If y'all have a problem, somebody come out here and bother y'all, you know, y'all give me a call back, me and my partner yeah. come back out. And I thought that was very, very nice. Mm-hmm. That the mere fact that, that, you know, the other one was sitting back, and we were kind of, you know, this day, this day and age, when you see a car that's sitting far off from everybody and it's unmarked and you don't know it's a police car, you, everybody be takes
little,
note,
little
you know.
Huh?
Everybody, it was so funny because all the parents were saying, okay, y'all see that car over there, right? You know, because it was far away.
Yeah.
And everybody kind of kept an eye on on the truck because yeah. the kids were, you know, playing mm-hmm. out there. And, you know, people come in. I watch too much TV, my son tells me. Because, you know, people get out the truck, they start blending in next to somebody's kids wrong. So everybody was on high alert.
Yeah, definitely.
And one person went over there and talked to the person in the truck. And he told me that he was, you know, Prince George's park police.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just checking on us. And so then later on, then when his partner came, I guess he must have felt comfortable after that. The other one got out the, out his car and came in and actually intermingled with us to let us know that he was his car was black too,
yeah,
but it was a little
yeah.
different.
Mm-hmm.
And that everything was fine. And, you know, if we didn't have, and you know, and that's good that you find that you have your, and I commended him, I saluted him because I do have the utmost respect for our police officers that are out here, no matter whether or not they're Bowie, you know, the county, the state, you know, the fire department, mm-hmm. the ambulance, you know, and especially our veterans and the people that are in the service. I take my hat off to you. I salute you all the time because I think that you are community. You said serve and protect. I don't care what branch you're in, it's all the same, you know. And with so much crazy stuff going on out here, I really commend you guys for the service that you do and trying to keep us safe, and especially with the crazy stuff that's going on in Florida mm-hmm. right now, you know. But God says that, you know, we're supposed to look out for each other,
right.
you know, and that we are supposed to love one another, no matter what minority we are,
right.
What race we are, they're all one and the same, you know, because you have a T-shirt said that last time you said all of us
we
are
all
human.
Humans.
We're all a human.
Yeah.
And I thought that was really great, too, because we all are human, you know, and we should respect one another as such. So whatever it is that that little spirit that got you guys going on down there in Florida, you know, throwing chairs at people and shooting people and beating people up at the dark. I let me tell you how I found out those things. Because my son used to show me YouTube stuff. So he'll show me the little clips that go on with YouTube that he said that I need to be aware of, you know.
Yeah,
and so.
The Montgomery, Alabama brawl.
Yeah, the government, Montgomery, Alabama brawl. You showed me that one too.
Yeah, that was in Alabama.
Yeah, so we.
Something happened in Florida, I missed that one.
Yeah, but the thing about throwing the chairs really got next to me. So I'm just saying that you gotta.
Nah, you right.
Yeah, you gotta be careful.
Yeah.
You know, out here, period. And I do. And then when whether I know you or not, I always speak, and I tell everybody have a blessed day, be blessed, be safe, be vigilant. You know, pay attention to what's your surroundings, whether it's day or night or wherever I meet you.
Mm-hmm.
And I send that message out to you today that you do need to be vigilant and pay attention about what's going on around you, day and night, and so far as our children are concerned. Now, you said something, and a guest that was around your same age, he's supposed to come back. He was supposed to come actually today. You filled him for somebody else again.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
He was supposed to come last week, I'm sorry, with Tom. And he does his own music and everything. But the week that he came on, then you came on the week after him.
Mm-hmm.
And the wisdom that you guys talked about, you would think that y'all knew each other, and y'all know you don't, but how we supposed to come together, you know, and stop doing all this violence to one another. And, you know, it was things that y'all said. In fact, Attorney Bell was so, with the other guy, when he sat down and talked to him, he said, you know, that's very profound hearing it come from a young man out your mouth. And then you turned around and did the same thing.
Yeah, and then I think like a week after that, I didn't hear it. That's crazy. I didn't hear it from somebody else I think I was at a funeral. Mm-hmm. Somebody else said something similar. I said, mm-hmm. wow, universe mm-hmm. is working.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So the Lord is really working, and he's trying to really reach out to you guys mm-hmm. because we have been around, you know what I mean? But nobody is really picking up that mantle mm-hmm. Now I see that y'all are, but I'm saying that, mm-hmm. and it's coming from the men. Somebody said to me at your event, mm-hmm. you know, one time it used to be the women that was out here that, you know, would do these things and get people together and come out and everything. Now you see that it's the men, and that's the truth. Mm-hmm. Now I see that it's the young men that are about something and being positive. Mm-hmm. Being positive, that are coming out and doing things that are positive things to try. And you guys are sending the same message, that the parents need to, you know, the ones that are not making sure that their children are doing, you know, I'm not saying anybody's doing bad parenting, because I cannot place blame on anybody. But we used to have a village, and I know that all of you remember that little slogan, even when you were young, you know, because, you know, the neighbors, if you did something wrong, one of the neighbors would come up to you and tell you, now I'm gonna tell your mother, okay? Mm. And if you don't, if I come back out here again, you can come to my house and sit until she come home, you know? But you ain't wanna beat her up or cuss her out, you understand what I'm saying? Because we looked out for each other. Yeah. And those are the things, the messages that you guys are trying to put back out there, that we need to look out for each other, watch out for each other. Shouldn't be no, because you said something to my kid, you know, as long as you said it in a respectful manner, you know, that I'm going to beat you up mm-hmm. or curse you out, you know. And I think that's the message that y'all are trying to get out now, that, you know, we need to look out for one another. Did I get that wrong?
No. But it is hard, because you got some people, like, they not right in the head, mentally ill, as far as you can't say nothing to their kid, whether mm-hmm. you know them or not. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I mean, it's just... It's 2023, so I mean, it's sometimes it's right just not to say nothing. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Well, you need to pay attention, and you need to be guided by your spirit. And spirit say, don't leave it alone. You know what I mean? But you can always call the police.
Yeah, definitely.
You know,
yeah.
If you think that it's something that's getting ready to get out of hand, because mm-hmm. that's not good. You know, I'm not gonna say not do anything. You don't have to be an approach.
Right.
Because you might get hurt yeah. and it get turned on you.
Like,
so no, I don't definitely recommend that you do that. But you can call 911, and then I know everybody got on their telephone. I didn't even know the 911 service had a real phone number, okay? But they sent that message out to everybody, telling that the service for the 911, if you were dialing it direct, that it's still 911, but the phone number has changed. So I'm quite sure everybody that had wear these watches or your phone came up with that same alert, you know. So no, you don't have to approach, but you can call, you know. And if you think that it's something that's going to get out of town, I mean out of hand.
Right.
Yeah. But the biggest thing is that I'm impressed by is that you young men around your age are really out here trying to get a message of peace, you know, and longevity, and being creative. You know, I mean, you've always been like that, but, and most of your friends have been like that, but to see other, like at the event, to see other people, one person came up to me and said, they called me Mama Duke. I didn't know what that meant a long time ago, okay, to my son. I was offended by it at first.
Ma Dukes.
And to finally my son told me, nah, Ma Duke is a term of endearment, okay? And so no, it's not. They not, because I thought about the dog Marmaduke, okay?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And they said, no, it's a term of endearment. And so he said, Marduke, he said, you see, we out here trying to do what's right. I mean, he seriously came to me. We out here trying to do the right thing. We're trying to create our own. We're not trying to be what you call, this way he explained to me. We're not trying to be entrepreneurs. We're trying to be businessmen. We're trying to create a product that everybody can use, you know, and sell, and let people know that we're out here trying to be businessmen. We have ideas and how to create things, and we're trying to do that, you know, so that we can do it the right way and not the wrong way. Aren't you proud of us? I said, I sure am, you know.
Yeah.
But that's what he said to me. He said that he wants people to know that y'all are not entrepreneurs, but y'all are actually businessmen trying to do things the right way. Does that sound?
Yeah, it sound right.
Yeah.
Can't put in no writer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, that was one of the other businessmen that was mm-hmm. sitting out there. But y'all have a lot of creative people that are out there. And I thank the Lord that he's trying to get us on the right point. I think that he's trying to get us right. I know that school opened up on Monday for this week, and then they'll be out next Monday. But they have a lack of school teachers. I want to say that to you. Because a lot of them are afraid to go back into the classroom because of all this violence that went on during COVID. Mm. And I think that's why they pulled them out and had them do
homeschool.
Mm. But there's a lack of in-room classroom teachers. So I just want to put that alert out there to you that if you are a school teacher, they are looking for in every county and every city in this area. They're looking for school teachers, okay? And they're paying you guys, and they're trying to give you better benefits than what you've had in the past. My mother keeps saying to me, I don't know why you don't go back into the classroom, you know? And that's a thought, okay? You know, but so I'm putting that out there. There are a lot of people that are out there. There are a lot of school systems that are out here that are trying to get school teachers. So even the colleges are having problems, you know, of getting people to come in. And all of them not teaching positions. They all kinds of positions that are in the school system. So, you know, if it's something that you've done in the past, as you know, you at the college or you've done at a trade school, or, you know, you've done in elementary, junior high, high school, go back out there and look on the websites and see whether or not it's a position for you. They also have positions that are, you can stay at home, okay? So you don't have to go to the classroom, but you can stay at home and, you know, help them out and assist them in different ways as well. So I'm just putting that out there like I always do. I try to give you information. And so was it anything that you wanted to talk about in particular?
No, not really. About the school, just want to wish the kids good luck. You know, have a great school year, you know, going back to school, you know. Mm-hmm. Be safe. I know driving, you know, the other type of job I do, I drive a lot. So, you know, traffic been real hectic lately because, you know, people back to school, parents trying to get their kids back, you know, on school on time. So it's just been a lot of traffic now that school is back. So just be aware of the kids, be aware of the kids, drivers, and the bikers and the skateboarders and the skaters and all that. That's it for real.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because I need something to think about that to make sure that the children are at the school buses. So they have to walk down your community because a lot of places in Bowie don't have sidewalks.
Slow down.
And so they walking in the streets. So, you know, when in your community, if you don't have a sidewalk and you know that these children are going to school early in the morning and they're coming home in the afternoon, mm-hmm. Early afternoon, that you need to be aware when you go through your community because some of these streets are not that wide, okay? Mm-hmm. So you need to pay attention of the teenagers, you know, that are getting off these school buses, as well as the younger kids mm-hmm. that are getting off the school buses in your community, okay? Because we definitely don't, there are a lot of them that are out there and that have gone back into the classroom. Mm-hmm. A lot of times when I was coming up, you didn't go back to school until after Labor Day. Mm-hmm. So some people are still on vacation, but you will, like you said, you will see that increase in traffic.
Yeah.
And you
will kids out. Slow down and do the speed limit. That's
yeah,
it.
Yeah. And slow extra down if you need to because they've changed. Oh, yeah. Pay attention to the speed limits at the schools and around them, okay? Because they've dropped the speed limits in some areas from 25 to like 15. So you need to pay attention and be aware of the speed limit on the streets that you're in during school time and be aware of those flashing lights because that means that that's the speed limit that you should use during that time, okay? So pay attention to those as well. We want to keep everybody safe. And, you know, after a while, you know, nighttime you know, when it, when they be coming home from school, it's going to start getting dark early, okay? So you need to be aware that that is coming, because we're in September, the day is the 31st of August. September around, October, I think that the light, that day and night changes again. So you need to be aware of that too, because a lot of accidents happen when, you know, those kids have to get up. I think is it dark they go to school in the I forget.
It's dark in the morning.
It's dark in the morning, and then it changes again. Then it's early, bright in the morning, and it's dark in the evening. So just be aware the time changes as well. I'm so glad that, like you said, your event was a success. It was a good thing to see family and members and friends, and a lot of your friends were, I saw them when they was like this.
Yeah,
you
like I said, it was like a family reunion.
And
everybody grown now.
And got children of their own.
Time. Got kids,
And
shout out to Black Boom Creations. That was ice cream.
That was a nice lady and her husband. They had their own ice cream truck. They gave the kids a little tour of the ice cream truck. And then some of them said they wanted to work, and so they worked for ice cream. That was nice.
It was.
To get them a feel of what it is to own your own business. We're talking about little kids.
Right.
And they gave them turns of being able to be their own ice cream truck. You know, business entrepreneur. And that was a good thing, because putting that in the kids here early. I can do this when I get this big, you know, and it's really not that hard, you know. Yeah. And they were really respectful, so it was really good.
Shout out to District Saul. They was out there.
Yeah, and shout out to them as well. They had a good event as
DJ
well.
DJ Frankie B.
And the DJ, the photographer that you had.
Yeah, shout out to Marcus.
And you had a person.
Was Carmen. Carmen Shaw.
And you had
a photographer and a videographer.
Photographer, video. Then you had this guy that when he came in, when he came and started speaking to everybody, he said he was the president of D.C. Kind of threw us off, because me and your aunt looked at each other and said, well, what that mean?
I missed that one.
And he was the singer. We were surprised, because he introduced himself to everybody. I'm the president of D.C. And I'm saying, okay. But he was a rapper.
Speaking in existence. Yeah. I want to say Pedro. It might have been Pedro. Shout out to Pedro. His name might have been Pedro.
Okay. He knew Frankie.
He did a little song so everybody could hear.
He did his two songs. He's getting ready to, he said he's getting ready to release one. He's going to have a release party soon. And he invited everybody out when he let us know, But and his name is the president of D.C. Now I'm trying to figure out where he came up with that one.
I don't know.
Okay. Because that's how he introduced himself. So he's supposed to be releasing a record soon. And I want to give him a shout out for him to even say that he's the president of D.C. I ain't know whether he was a council person or not, you know. I ain't know. But we did hear him sing, so it worked out. But it was for all of you guys that came out for free, just to make sure that everybody had a good day for the end of the summer. I just want to say thank you, you know, and all those free products that you gave away, I want to say thank you. And so with that, for Jeremiah Interdenominational Missionary Church, we want to say, may the Lord keep watch over you.
Actor in an ad that was given 12 seconds to remind you that if you're high, just don't drive. Because if you feel different, you drive different. It's illegal to drive high everywhere anyway.
Hey, did you know 2.4 million loving cats and dogs in shelters and rescues need our help to find a home? Let's go to the shelterpetproject.org and meet a few who are in a shelter near you. Harlow. Oh, she's one great listener who loves to hear all your stories. My kind of cat. Cerulo is a sweet, goofy boy who's eager to please. Sounds just like another dog I know. So go to the shelterpetproject.org, search your local shelters and rescues, and go for a cuddle with your next best friend. Adopt.